SDS Science Snapshot Series. Closed captioning, subtitles, and automatic foreign language translations are available in the YouTube settings, at least when using a desktop browser. My name is Esther Haars, President and CEO of the Shwachman-Diamond Syndrome Alliance. Our mission is to accelerate therapy development and the cure for SDS, in particular to eliminate the deadly leukemia risk it brings, in a time frame that matters to our children and thousands of SDS patients worldwide, turning hope into action. Science has made incredible progress in the past few years, and we will make sure all SDS patients benefit. Today's video is about ribosomes and how they relate to SDS. All of us are made up of billions of little cells. Each cell type has different jobs to do in our bodies, and they do their jobs through proteins. Proteins are chains of small molecules called amino acids. There are 20 different amino acids, and they interact with each other in different ways to fold up the chain into a specific 3D structure. We have thousands of different proteins in each of our cells, and each protein is responsible for a particular step in helping the cells thrive and do their job. The proteins are all made according to a recipe encoded in our DNA. Each gene, which is a small stretch of DNA, encodes one specific protein. So the information encoded in genes on the DNA gets translated into proteins. This translation step is done by so-called ribosomes. The genes on the DNA are first transcribed into shorter RNA molecules. These shorter RNA molecules are then fed into ribosomes, and the ribosomes then read the information on it to string together chains of amino acids in the correct order to form the right 3D structure. These folded chains are the proteins, and their 3D structure is essential for them to do their job. Most of our genes in each of our cells come in pairs, one from our mother and one from our father. One of the millions of genes is called SBDS, which encodes a protein with the same name, the SBDS protein. The specific job of the SBDS protein is to help the ribosomes get ready to work. Ribosomes come in two parts, a bigger subunit and a smaller one. Ribosomes don't work when the two parts are separated. When it's time for them to start working on making protein, the two parts join together. This is where our SBDS protein is needed. It catalyzes the two ribosomal parts to join together to build a functional ribosome complex. In over 90% of SDS patients, that's where the problem is. Due to a mutation in both copies of the SBDS gene, they don't make enough SBDS protein, and as a result, they are not able to assemble enough ribosomes. And therefore, the cells cannot make as much of all the proteins they usually make. Scientists refer to this challenge as ribosomal stress. It can trigger cell death or senescence through the P53-mediated pathways. More about P53 in another video. Ribosomes and SBDS are essential component of every cell in the body. If there's not enough, like in SDS patients, many organ systems are affected, such as digestion, bones, brain, blood, immune system. Every patient is affected to different degrees. Some have very mild symptoms or none at all and may get undiagnosed for a long time, while others have severe and life-threatening manifestations. The reasons for these differences are not well understood. It's also not well understood why some organ systems are stronger affected than others. You may have noticed that I said not enough SBDS protein. This means that SDS patients can still make a little bit, resulting in a little bit of functional ribosomes, because without any, they would not be viable. This feature of SDS offers several additional targets for therapy development, in addition to the new frontier of gene therapy. Because one of the most common SBDS mutations is leaky, that is, it can produce some functional protein, several strategies can be employed to increase SBDS protein expression, or target other proteins involved in building functional ribosomes. I'll cover some of these strategies in another video. Stay tuned. Thank you for watching. This video is part of a series on SDS science. Learn more about Shwachman-Diamond syndrome on the SDS Alliance website at www.sdsalliance.org and follow us on our social media sites like facebook.com/sdsalliance. See you again soon.